Japan, Canada, and me. 日本とカナダの外交90周年おめでとうございます。
My first time in Japan would have almost been 10 years ago now, so it's been quite a while. It was in Tokyo, and it was for the NHK Trophy, a Grand Prix event on the ISU Grand Prix Figure Skating Series. And my first impression of Japan was that the people were so incredibly welcoming and friendly. I was arriving at the hotel lobby, and there were people lined up already for autographs, for gifts, and I was so shocked at how kindthese people could be. And from there, the initial warmth and respect that I got from these people made me want to connect with them more and actually spurred my interest in Japanese language and culture. So I think it was a really wonderful experience and something that I'll remember for the rest of my life. From the first time that I was in Japan, I wanted to be able to connect with the Japanese fans and be able to speak with them and understand their feelings a little bit more. And for that very reason is actually what I started learning Japanese. So I feel like the more my Japanese ability has progressed, I feel a tangible improvement in the way that I can understand the people there. So I want to continue that into the future. As for using my Japanese skills in a work environment, I would like to be able to work in a short-term basis in Japan at some point in my life, whether that be in a capacity, in a skating capacity as a figure skating coach, or in the foreign relations capacity in what I've been studying at university. I'd like to be able to use my Japanese skills in a working environment. Japan, Canada, and me.